Alright, poops. Mama gonna food you now. Here we go.
Here we go, baby. Here we go.
With built-in security that protects your kids, no matter what they're up to. Protects your info and gives you 24/7 peace of mind. But if it's connected, it's protected.
Here, my big girl.
Even that pet camera thingy.
Oh.
Can your internet do that? Xfinity XFi can, because it's simple, easy, awesome.
What makes every month truck month at Sunset Chevrolet? It's not the Chevrolet prices and incentives. They're all the same at every Chevy dealership, and so are the financing rates. Then what could it be?
Well, you just get more at Sunset.
Like a huge inventory. And Sunset's exclusive extras like oil changes for life and warranty protection for life. That combo alone will save you thousands down the road. Speaking of roads, find new roads, the Traffic Avenue and Tiny Overhead Center. Because every month is truck month at Sunset Chevrolet.
You're such a bug girl.
You know by now, malls, restaurants, and movie theaters all closed as people are urged to practice social distancing. Now, one independent film company is releasing a new movie that you can watch in the comfort of your own home. The producers of Phoenix, Oregon will share all revenue on a 50-50 basis with the group of theaters where it would have been shown. With us now via Skype from San Antonio, Texas, one of the film's co-stars, Jesse Borrego. Jesse, thank you so much for joining us. It's kind of interesting because the movie itself is about an unpublished comic book artist who's trying to start his own business. So you have art imitating life a little bit here, trying to kind of start his own business.
Absolutely.
You're trying to save
that's
some
a good
of
girl.
These movie movies.
That's a good girl, Emma.
Well, you know, Phoenix, Oregon was a nice indie film we did out of Oregon. Great cast, James LeGros, Drugstore Cowboy, just an incredible Lisa Edelstein, Deirdre Bader. So we got together with these Oregon filmmakers, Gary London and Annie London, and the writer-director, Gary, really
I'm hungry. I'm a hungry girl.
Now that we had a chance to exhibit Phoenix, Oregon, and we were participating with these theaters, that when all of this happened, we pivoted onto our online platform, that we wanted to give back to the small business of the small theaters that were going to show us. So we decided to participate in the revenue with them, keep them in the loop. And right now everybody's looking for entertainment in this time of uncertainty and stress. And so we felt that we could not only entertain people, but we wouldn't leave behind the businesses that had supported us. We had like about 20 theater chains around the country that were going to show this film. So it's a win-win.
I'm curious, Jesse, do you think this, the online movie theater thing, is something that you will see more of in the future? Or was this just kind of to fill the niche needed by the pandemic we're having right now?
Well, I think it's a little of both. You know, it's something that's coming for a while. We still love to go to the theater. We still love to see it on the big screen. But ultimately, everyone wants to be in the comfort of their own home when they're absorbing their entertainment. Everybody downloads their stuff and saves it and streams it later.
You're so sweet,
so,
Emma.
We always had that in the plan, and I think
you're
just
so sweet.
Being able to pivot that quickly.
Mama loves you.
Being independent.
Mama loves you, big girl.
We didn't want to leave that theater behind because they've committed to us. They committed to putting us on the big screen, sharing us with their audience. And so we thought that, hey, as we're doing this, let's bring them along with us. And that way we can help these small businesses that are shuttered. I mean, they got all their titles taken out of the weekend. They have no opening weekends. And we were still able to show our film at the same time, share with these small businesses that are under stress at this moment. And it's a
you eat better than babies do.
Like
you eat off a spoon better than a lot of babies I've fed.
He's a frustrated artist, and I'm a frustrated pizza chef. And I decided to rope him into opening a Polarama pizzeria, and the rest is comedic history.
Yeah, you know, it's funny because you talk about the ripple effect. The economy right now is clearly suffering, and movie theaters are part of that.
Macaroni for dinner again.
They all think, you know what? Here's the deal. You know, this is not gonna bring these businesses back. It's not gonna pay their next year's mortgage, but it will help the businesses stay alive. There's this ripple effect. It's not just theaters,
oopsie,
but other businesses
down
the line, and actors and people like that are gonna make some money off this thing. So is that kind of the concept?
Absolutely. It's always a good gig with us, especially in the independent scene. You know, it's always about making this kind of relationship with these smaller theater chains.
Good stuff.
They compete for these big titles, but also have to survive, you know. And so I think in this moment of stress, you know, Phoenix, Oregon, and if you go to PhoenixOregonMovie.com, that's how you watch it. every ticket that you buy, all of these theater chains will participate with us in the revenue. And it was a great thing because this past weekend, when we opened, they were shut, and yet they saw some revenue from this title. So we're really excited about this win-win, and it may be the new normal, you know, this type of participation. Of course, everyone still wants to go to the big screen, and I don't think that's ever going to go away.
Mama loves you to pieces, baby doll.
Again, open an indie film, and you can't compete with some of these big Marvel superhero movies. Yeah. You know, we're streaming it ourselves. We don't even have a streaming company behind us. Yeah. You explore the movie.com and you can watch it for $6.50.
The funny thing, Jesse, is I drove through Phoenix, Oregon a couple of weeks ago. I mean, it's this cool small town, right? It's funny because, you know, the whole concept here is you pay $6.50. So you pay $6.50 and you get to see the movie one time, right? It streams one time like the movie. You can't just pick it and it's a one-time thing. Tell us about that.
But you get $48 to watch it, like most purchased to watch online films. But I believe that we are initially, because we're participating with these theaters, a lot of first-timers that rent this film, we'll call it a rental, right? They're actually going to be able to download it, get a link to download it when it's available for purchase. So they actually get a 2-for-1 with the ticket. So it's a win-win all the way around.
Full?
We really want to, again,
are you getting full, baby doll?
Scene, but especially these small theaters that had to shutter their doors right on this weekend when all of this happened. So, you know, these people struggle sometimes in this day and age of competing with big titles. So I think for us, it's about giving back to each other. And then when you watch Prince Oregon, like you said, you realize
now you're making
story,
that big a mess.
The narrative is about people helping each other and loving each other and supporting each other's dreams. What a message this time.
It really is. It's a great effort. Jesse Borrego, thank you so much.
You're
for coming on.
I just love you.
Appreciate it.
I just love you.
PhoenixOregonMovie.com. PhoenixOregonMovie.com. In case we didn't get it, PhoenixOregonMovie.com. Jesse Borrego, best of luck to you. Good luck with the movie. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Welcome. COVID-19 continues to spread across the country. The U.S. now ranking third in the world in cases. Globally, over 173 countries have now been affected, with total cases reaching over 470,000. You all know the streets are empty, stores are closed, and social distancing is the new worldwide trend. What the pandemic looks like around the world is next. And as you see the numbers there on the Johns Hopkins page, you see the 471,000 total on the
You
line.
Are
Keep
so cute.
We just crunched the numbers coming in late at night from Wednesday. And what we're seeing is in New York City, they're seeing some sort of a leveling off, right? So the number of cases today and the number of cases yesterday is very close to being the same. The
almost gone. Almost gone, Puds.
Versus yesterday, almost identical. So could it be what the governor says is a bit of flattening? It'll take a few more days to get it passed, but there is some evidence. What the pandemic looks like around the world. Next.
Don't wait for a chip like this to crack your whole windshield. With SafeLight's exclusive resin, you get a strong repair that you can trust. Plus, with most insurance, SafeLight repair. A
couple more bites, be all gone, baby doll.
Diamonds, the timeless gift. The jewelry exchange has thousands of GIA diamonds at the guaranteed lowest price. Half carat solitaires, $4.99, 1 carat, $9.90, 2 carat, $24.90, and 1 carat studs, $5.99. Buy factory direct and save. The jewelry exchange direct.
These elderly Jews have taken the bus from across the city to come to this fellowship distribution spot and get food that they can't afford.
There is an emergency food crisis for elderly Holocaust survivors in the
form. All right, baby, last bite.
This is a crisis.
Last bite, put.
Holocaust survivors are struggling to survive. They're starving, have little money for food, electricity, or medicine.
Just 25.
Last one. It's all gone. All gone, poops. All gone. Let's see. You didn't make too bad of a mess. You actually did pretty good today. Let's see.